I'll say the first part, you say the second. Merry
Christmas!
Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey! Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Lead music's pretty easy.
I'm done.
I thought...
Thank you.
I thought it took a lot of talent. You kept telling me it, man.
This is all done with smoke and mirrors. Don't you
okay. What's another great Christmas song?
What's my password?
We'll sing Jingle Bells again if Bob Mahan will come up here and do an interpretive dance of it. Huh? Come on up, Bob. Okay, I don't guess we will. I want to welcome everyone to worship on Christmas morning. We're going to have a fun time today. I hope there's some acts you don't follow. Dogs and children, and I'm going to mess up today, but we're hoping this is going to be a great day. But let's begin by going to God in prayer. Father, we appreciate that you love us, God, more than we can put into words. And we thank you for the holiness of this day, the joy of this day, Father. We ask now that you bless us with your presence. May the joy of what we celebrate today be alive in our hearts and our minds and everything we do and say. Father, we're going to sing praises to you. We're going to come around your table again. And Father, we do it totally in remembrance of your Son, what he did for us. Father, thank you again for this time we have together. And we pray this in Jesus' most holy, Jesus' precious name. All of God's people say it. Amen. Amen. Again, Merry Christmas.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive.
joy to the world. The Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him room. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. Joy to the world, the Savior reigns. Let all their songs employ. Our fields and floods, frost fields and plains. Repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy. Repeat, repeat the sounding joy.
I need to ask everybody to be in prayer that what I'm going to do this morning works. That it works. I have no idea where we're going to go.
We do that every week.
Yeah, just pray as you do every week that this works. If it doesn't, how many of you were here last night? Okay, those of you that were here last night, just remember we had a good service last night. but we're looking forward to this. By the way, we had 685 people here last night, crammed in this room. That's fantastic. Says deleting notes, which is what we don't want to do. Okay. I'm going to ask several of my friends to come up here. Sophia, if you'll come up, come on up. Vivian and Charlotte, where are you? Come on up, gals. Come over here. I'll help you get up there. Wait, here's what we're going to do. We're going to move you out here where everybody can see you, okay? Except Mom and Dad. I'm trying to line that up. Okay. Vivian and Charlotte, come on up. Now, you all are twins, right? Yeah. That would have been hard to figure out. Here you go. And here you go. Come on up here. There you go. Come on over. There you go. Okay. Now, we're not to steal the show. I've got a microphone for you. Do y'all mind speaking in a microphone? You sort of like it, don't you, Sophia? Yeah, sort of. Now, you're Charlotte. Oh. You're Vivian. No, okay.
My name's Charlotte. Her name is Vivian.
Okay, you're Charlotte and you're Vivian. Okay. And you're twins, right? Tell me, just hold this mic here for a second. Can you hold it? Tell me what it means that you're a twin.
Because we love each other.
Okay, that's good. Well, you got them all to go, oh, and they never do that for me. Did you all go see Santa Claus this year? Did you? Okay. Did you go see Santa Claus? Do you think adults get to go see Santa Claus and talk to him?
No.
No? Why not? Tell me why adults don't ever talk to Santa Claus.
Because they're not kids.
Okay. Do you think there'd be any other reason? What if I showed you a picture? Would you like to see a picture? Look at the picture that's behind you.
Because.
Well, they're supposed to be. There it is. Oh, well, tell them that.
That's a fake Santa.
Oh, that's a fake Santa. Huh? It's Vivian's turn. Okay, here, Vivian. Vivian, hold that. I want you to tell everybody. Did you get a Christmas gift this morning?
Yeah.
Who from?
Santa.
Okay, tell everybody what Santa brought you.
A cat has babies inside its tummy.
Oh, okay. A cat that has babies inside? I pray that God will forgive me what I'm getting ready to ask you next, okay? How do you think those babies got inside that cat's tummy? Okay, because they're just cats. That's a good, safe answer, okay? That's a good answer. You think that's a fake Santa Claus?
Yes, what? He has glasses.
Because he has glasses. Well, boy, I'm pretty disappointed, but it explains a lot that happened this morning, okay? I asked Santa Claus for a new motorcycle, and I got up, and I got biscuits and gravy instead. Okay? Sophia, I want you to do me a favor. First of all, where's your mom and dad?
Over there.
Make them stand up. Say, stand up, Dad, Mom.
Stand up, Dad and Mom.
Okay. Now, while they're standing there, I want you to answer me another question, okay? Did your daddy get your mother anything for Christmas that you know about?
Yes, a Paladonia.
A what?
A Paladonia.
A Paladonia? Patagonia. What is a Patagonia? What is a Patagonia?
It's like a sweater.
A sweater?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It's not really a sweater, but it has buttons on it.
Okay, it has buttons on it. Was it pretty?
Yeah, it was blue.
It was blue, okay. Did your mommy get your daddy anything for Christmas? Oh, I bet she did, though. I bet she did. By the way, that is a beautiful outfit all three of you are wearing. Okay? Did your, what's my name?
Poppy.
Okay, tell them my name.
Poppy.
Poppy.
Okay. Did your Grandma Linda, did she get you anything for Christmas? A pig and a lamb, okay. Do the pig and the lamb have babies in their tummy? Okay. What did she get you?
She got me
A horse with flowers. And she actually got like a lamb too.
A lamb suit? Okay. Do you girls, any of you three girls, have a favorite Christmas song?
Yeah.
What's yours?
Rocking Around the Christmas Tree.
Rocking Around the Christmas Tree. Would you do me a favor? Would you sing part of it for me? Here, hold the microphone.
Rocking around the Christmas tree in a Christmas holy rock.
Do you have a favorite Christmas song? Huh? You want to sing part of it? Here you go.
How are you singing that, Vivian?
I got that.
You can do it, Vivi. They're organizing.
Frosty the Snowman was a joy. Jolly happy soul with a corn cob pop and a button nose with his eyes made out of coal. Frosty the Snowman, a jolly
You gals are wonderful. You are fabulous young ladies. I want to. Yeah, look, there I'm telling him, and he said, I wouldn't do that on Christmas morning at church if I were you. But why do we have Christmas?
Christmas morning.
Because it's Jesus' birthday.
Okay, Jesus' birthday. That's good. Why do you think we have Christmas, Sophia?
Because Jesus died on the cross for his sins.
Okay. Do you want to tell people about that? You don't know? Who would like to tell the Christmas story? Okay.
How do you do it?
You just tell it. You held your hand up and said you wanted to tell it. You want me to get you started?
Yeah.
There was a baby born in a manger.
You mean baby Jesus?
Yeah, baby Jesus.
Laid him in a manger, oh Lord?
Mm-hmm.
Laid him in a manger, oh Lord. Laid him in a manger, oh Lord. The people came and coming and the train done gone.
Yeah, now Vivian, you can tell the rest of it, she said. It's a musical. It's a musical. And in Luke 2, written by Bernstein.
How do you do it?
Huh?
How do you do it?
There was a baby born in a manger, and his name was?
Jesus.
Who was his mama and daddy?
Mary and Joseph.
Mary and Joseph. What did Joseph do for a living? Daddies have to work. What's your daddy do?
My daddy farms.
Your daddy farms? Yeah. What's your daddy do?
He wrestles.
That's interesting. Does he know Ronda Rousey?
No.
No? Okay. Does he coach wrestling at Daniel Boone High School?
Yes.
Okay. I thought I could clear that up. Does he also work sometimes at DB Electric? I think he does. For his father-in-law and his uncle-in-law, Mike Lewis. They're going to be open, by the way, half a day on Judgment Day. Okay, this will be the last one. Can you tell me the Christmas story? Okay. Okay, just let's start. They're in the manger. Who came to see them afterwards? I want you, Sophia, to tell everybody why it's real important to know who Jesus is.
Because he's died.
Because he died?
No, he's God.
He's God. Okay, I misunderstood. I'm sorry. Because he's God. What did God do for us?
He died on the cross for our sins, okay. So we did go to heaven.
Okay, that is really good. I think you young ladies are three of the most dynamic young ladies I've ever met. And I want to tell you on behalf of, does it make you nervous being up here?
No.
No, it didn't. Well, do you want to go sit with your mom and dad now? No, not really. It's sort of fun, isn't it? I think you've done a fantastic job, and we want to thank you very much, okay? You can go sit. Vivian and Charlotte, thank you all very, 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 very much. And your parents here, your mom here, I'll have them stand. There's Mama. Okay. Fantastic. Now, you know, Scripture says we're to be like little children, doesn't it? And I just thought this would be fantastic. They've got it right. They've got it right. But we are to be like them. Now, the next group I'm not real sure about, but I want Jackson Utzman, if he'll come up. It's my better judgment, Isaac Massard. Ben Hull. And then Kenton and Holston come on up. They didn't know they were going to do this. Now, Ben, okay. Now, your brother, so I'm going to have you share a seat. Because this will be entertaining in and of itself, you all sharing a seat. Okay. Now, can you boys share a seat and not fight? Yeah, okay. This probably not going to go well. Okay. Isaac, we're going to start with you. Okay? I'm going to let you hold the mic. And just let me ask you a couple of questions. First one, we'll just real easy. Your dad's name is?
Todd.
Todd Massard?
Yes.
Is that song? Test, 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 test. Is it on? Blue. Let's go with the red. Okay. I think it's operator error up here. Test. Okay. Your father's name is?
Todd.
Todd. What's his last name?
Massard.
What's his middle name?
Edward.
Edward. T.E. Massard. Okay. Todd Edward Massard. Did he get your mother anything for Christmas that you know of?
Yeah.
What'd he get her?
A big rain jacket that is really thick. I don't want to wear.
Okay. That she doesn't want to wear or you don't want to wear?
I don't.
Okay, but it's a big rain jacket that is really thick.
Yeah, made for winter.
Made for winter, okay, so keep her warm. Did you get any gifts this morning?
Yeah.
What'd you get?
Tennessee hat.
Tennessee hat. And we won't even bring that up. He's an Ohio State Buckeye fan, and you got a Tennessee hat, right?
Uh-huh.
So that means that your dad's growing closer to the Lord.
Yeah.
Is there anything you'd want to say to people? I mean, we'll come back to you in a minute, but is there anything you think everybody out here ought to know about Christmas?
No.
Okay. Jackson, your mom, dad's name?
Jason and Mindy.
Jason and Mindy. What's Jason's middle name, do you know?
Lance.
Lance, Jason, Lance, like Lance Crackers. Mm-hmm. Okay. What did you get for Christmas? You got your gifts yet? What'd you get?
I got a PlayStation.
A PlayStation? Electronic Christmas, right? What'd your dad get your mom?
He got her a...
Is she on the naughty list?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, let's ask it the other way then and see who's not on the naughty list. Did your mom get your dad anything for Christmas?
Yeah, he got some socks.
How would you feel if you got up on Christmas morning all excited and went in and under the tree, what you had was socks?
Terrible.
Terrible. How do you think he felt when he got up this morning and went in and what was under the tree was socks?
I don't know.
Yeah. Okay. Holston?
I'm Holston.
Well, I know you're Holston. Holston, have you opened your gifts yet?
No.
Well, put the mic up there where people can hear you. Have you opened your gifts yet?
No.
When are you going to open them?
After church?
Well, we're going to be at church till 3 o'clock.
Oh, man.
Do you think there's some gifts there from Santa Claus when you get home?
Yes.
Okay. Kenton? You've not gotten your gifts yet either, have you?
No.
Wait till after church?
Yes.
Okay. Well, that's pretty funny.
And my dad got a... underwear for Christmas.
Who did?
My dad got underwear for Christmas.
Your dad got underwear for Christmas. Kenton?
What?
I'm back here. When you get done, you say anything you want, I'll come back up.
And even Jonathan got some underwear for Christmas, too.
Oh, okay. Well, we've talked enough about underwear for Christmas. Okay. Ben, what do you think of these guys?
They're weird.
They're weird? Well, I'm going to show you weird, okay? I want you to look over and say, Daddy, stand up and show everybody your jacket.
Body your jacket.
Now there's weird. It's like a thin, dark-haired Santa Claus over there. What did you get for Christmas? You opened your gifts yet?
Mm-hmm.
What'd you get?
A video game for my Wii U.
A video game for what?
My Wii U and a Lego set, and I think it was 636 pieces.
A Lego set with 636 pieces? Would it be okay if the preacher came over after church and played Legos?
I have to build it first.
Oh, so no?
Yeah. Yes, after I build it for days and days.
Well, I'll come over March, April, sometime like that, we'll play, okay?
Yes.
Okay. I want to ask you guys a real important question because I've been thinking about this a lot. I want all of you to think about it, okay? And Thumbs up, buddy. How old do you think Santa Claus is?
215
years. Okay, 215 years. How old do you think?
1,000.
1,000? Okay. How old do you think I am?
35?
Yeah, that's... How old do you think our Santa Claus is?
250 years old.
250? Okay, so we got 1,250. How old do you think I am?
55.
55? Okay. Next one's a 20. We stop at once, okay? I'll find you a one. How old do you think Santa Claus is?
9,999.
So in his next birthday, he'll be 10,000 years old. Yeah. When do you think his birthday is?
Right now, today.
Same day as Jesus? Okay. This will be interesting. How do you think Santa Claus is?
One.
So he was just born a year ago. How old am I? How old do you think I am, Kent?
Two.
Two, okay. How old do you think Santa Claus is, Ben?
10,155.
So next question, how old do you think the preacher is? Do you know who the preacher is?
Yes.
Who's the preacher?
You.
Okay, how old do you think I am?
45.
45, yeah. We're going to be passing out a lot of $1 bills. So, the preacher is 62, which means his next birthday, I'll be 63.
Three.
Okay. Let me ask all of you a real important question. Ben, do you want to start it? Tell me the story of Christmas or why we have Christmas.
Because of Jesus' birth.
Okay, because of Jesus' birth. That's a good answer. Okay. Jackson, I'll be back. Jackson, why do you think we have Christmas?
Because God sent his one and only son to come down to die on the cross for the forgiveness of our sins.
Excellent. Excellent. Both of you. Excellent. Isaac, tell me about Christmas.
Jesus came to earth because he wanted to die on the cross for the forgiveness of our sins so we could have a way to heaven.
Okay. How old do you think Jesus is?
2,566.
Okay. What if I told you he's eternal? He was alive before he came to earth, and he's still alive. Does that make sense? It's hard to think about, isn't it? Yeah. Why do you think we have Christmas?
Because St. Nicholas helped the three girls to not be stoned to death in Jesus' birth on earth.
Because St. Nicholas helped the three girls not be stoned to death for Jesus' birth. Okay.
Because he loved Jesus so much.
Because he loved Jesus so much. St. Nicholas did? Uh-huh. Okay. That's in 1 Ben-Hur, the third chapter, if you've never read it. Okay. Now, I want you to tell everybody about Jesus, okay? Just tell them. Now, but don't be silly. Just tell them about Jesus for me, kid.
Okay.
God sent his son, Jesus Christ, the Lord, who
came and God sent his son Jesus as a little baby, and he grew up to be 13, and he came and he knew what was going to happen, and he died on the cross and rise from the dead for us so we can have the eternal life to go to heaven, and so we can go into heaven with him so we can do right stuff and don't break the commandments of what Moses got. And he loved us so much he wanted to come and die on the cross for all our sins that we had done wrong. And he was the Lord and the Savior, and then we had communion so we can learn about his body and blood that he shed on the cross for us in his blood. And he loved us so much.
Ben, do you think he left anything out of that story?
No.
Okay. Well, then I want you to look at him and say, Kenton, my friend. Say that. Kenton, my friend.
Kenton, my friend.
Amen.
Amen.
All right. Isaac, do you think there's anything got left out?
No.
Well, then say, Kenton, my friend.
Kenton, my friend.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay. Same thing.
Kenton, my friend. Amen.
All right. Kenton, my brother.
Kenton, my brother. Amen, dude. Well, then my brother. Amen, little dude.
I really appreciate you. Is there something you want to say?
Yeah.
Okay, here.
I got Madden 17 for Christmas.
Okay, you'd forgotten that, didn't you? He got Madden 17 for Christmas. Who'd you get that from?
Either my mom or Santa Claus. I don't know. I don't put them under the tree.
Okay, so it doesn't matter who it came from. You just got it, didn't you?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I can't go to the Hull's house to March or April. So could I come play Madden 17 with you someday between
now
and then? Okay.
I got 3 Wii controllers.
3 Wii controllers?
Yeah, come
okay.
on and play.
Okay.
Yeah, I guess well, I'm safe. You come play too.
Okay, is there anybody else you want to invite? Could we all come today? Everybody come over today?
Jackson and Jason, that's
out. Okay. Okay, we're going to close. Kenton has asked if he could say something else.
Holston, my brother, amen, little duty.
I don't know what you said, but I'm not going to ask and try to repeat it.
No, I said, Holston, my brother, amen, little duty.
Oh, okay, we'll just leave all of this alone. Hey, dude. Run back to your mom and dad, give them a big hug, say Merry Christmas, and have them stand when you go back, okay? Where are they? Mom and Dad, thank you. Stand up, Mom and Dad. Okay. Run back to your mom and dad. Give them a big hug and have them stand up. Ben, run back to your mom and that guy in the funny red coat, your dad. Have them stand and give them a big hug and kiss your mom on the cheek, okay? You guys give your mom a kiss. It'll be the best Christmas present she gets. Run back, Mom and Dad. Give them a hug. Have them stand. They've got a pretty good grasp, don't they? I'm going to ask a very special friend to come up here to sort of close for us today. His name is Liam White. And if he'll come on up. And does your brother want to come and just sit up here? Jackson, you want to come and just sit? You don't? Because he's got stage fright. Liam, okay. Let me ask you a couple of questions, okay? What's your name?
Liam White.
What's your middle name?
Robinson.
Robinson. What's your brother's name?
Jackson White.
What's his middle name?
Clark.
Clark. Good name, isn't it? Yeah. Who am I?
David.
David, okay. What do you call me?
Poppy.
Why do you call me Poppy?
Because you're my grandfather.
Yeah, I'm your grandfather. And a lot of people maybe hadn't met you, so we're going to sit up here and talk a while and brag because you're my grandson, okay? What did Santa bring you? You just got it. About you and your brother, what?
My brother got a Kindle.
A Kindle? What did you get?
A Lego set.
Did Santa Claus bring anything and leave it in Florida for you and you caught him on the camera?
No, we didn't catch him on the camera, but he gave us kayaks.
Kayaks, okay. We'd known the Kindle and the Lego set was so big, he probably wouldn't have had to bring the kayaks, would he? I want you to read something, okay? I want you to start reading and read the pink. You need me to hold it or have you got it?
So Joseph also went up to the from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judah to the Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to marry to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for a baby to be born. And she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them.
Would you read the blue part too?
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over the flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger."
Okay. That is the Christmas story, isn't it? About Jesus being born. Why do we have Christmas?
Because Jesus was born and died on the cross for us.
Okay. How old is Santa Claus?
2016 years old.
2016 years old. Why do you think we have Santa Claus?
To give presents since Jesus died. Well, Jesus died on the cross.
So Santa Claus reminds us
that Jesus died on the cross.
Okay, so you've married the two. That's pretty good. Pretty good. I'm glad you're here this week.
Why?
Because grandpas like it when their grandsons are around.
I never knew that.
Oh, didn't you? Yeah. I try to talk to you more often. You're Liam, right?
Yes.
Yeah, you're Liam. I thought I recognized you. How old are you?
8.
And you got some Legos from Santa Claus that say age what?
9 through 14.
So you can't play with them till your next birthday, right?
No.
Okay. Thank you very much. And I'm glad you're here. What have we done this week? What have you done that's been fun this week?
Shotguns.
Shotguns. We probably should have not talked about. What else have you done this week?
I forgot.
Okay, well, I'm glad we spent money doing it then. So, did we have some bonfires?
Yes.
Where?
At my grandfather's house.
At Poppy's house?
No, at my other grandfather's house.
Who's your other grandfather?
Uncle Robert.
Oh, Uncle Robert, okay. Well, if you all don't mind, I'll join you today for Christmas dinner, you and Uncle Robert and Nani and all the family. If you don't mind a stranger coming in, okay?
You're not a stranger.
Okay. Thank you very much. You want to run back to your mom and dad? at his other grandfather's house, Uncle Robert. We affectionately call it the Clark compound. So it's been a good way to celebrate Christmas. The innocence of children that Jesus said we are to be like. They don't question, they just believe, don't they? And they believe, as every one of them told us, that Jesus came, died, and rose for our sins. And we come together every week and talk about it and talk about it. We remember. And I hope that's what Christmas is for every one of us. I want to commend everybody that's here. Coming on Christmas morning screams to the world around you the importance of Christ. And I think it's been a great day to be here. We're going to sing again. We treat this as an invitation time, and I will tell you it is. I will tell you I'll be back around the library if there's anybody who would want to make this a day of accepting Christ, being buried with him in baptism. Come up while we're singing. But it's been a great day, a fantastic day. What are we going to sing, Jimmy?
How deep the Father's love for us.
How deep the Father's love for us. We've seen it with these children that are up here today. Absolutely, absolutely so much to be thankful for. If you're in here this morning, you're a child that got some gifts today, stand up. Children under, say, 12 or 13, stand up. Glad y'all are in here this morning. Thank you for being here with us this morning. We're going to sing. We're going to stand. Blake, I'm going to ask you when we're done if you'll come close us in prayer, okay?
Dying breath has
Michael, come on up. Let's sit and interview this gentleman too. Give him a mic. Mike, I'm just going to ask you, tell everybody who you are.
My name is, Michael Anthony, freshman at Milligan. Go Buffs.
Yeah, okay. How were your grades?
They were great. They were good. A few B's, but the rest A's for the rest.
Okay.
For the most part.
He's there on a scholarship at Milligan and is from our church. Tell everybody, and this is very important this morning. I didn't know this was going to happen. Tell everybody how you ended up coming to worship at Boone's Creek.
I did a program. It's called Coalition for Kids, and we used to we go to the youth building when I was like in sixth or seventh grade, and they kept inviting me, and I was like, you know what, I'm gonna actually go. So I just went, and I just kept going ever since, and I fell in love with it.
Who brought you the first few times?
Aaron Boyd did.
Aaron
and
Boyd?
The Boyds, Keith and Rebecca,
okay.
And Taylor.
And then and Brandon got involved.
Yeah, and Brandon too.
And James, and then you've been real close with the whole youth group, Andrew and Jamie and all. Yeah. And he, the scholarship you're at Milligan is called the...
It's the Betty Goa Scholarship.
Yeah, the Goa Scholarship that a lady that has more money than you and I made available for students to be able to go. And it would have been hard, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
It would have been real hard.
Yeah.
And, so I want to thank the church. They've been behind you and Milligan and all they've done. Tell them why you came forward this morning.
Well, I felt for years that I've had a calling to go into ministry, and I felt like it's time that I decide and declare it to you guys, because you guys are very important to me. So I wanted to make that known and do like youth ministry work and stuff like that.
Okay, fantastic. So a call into ministry. Amen. Wants to go into ministry. Praise God. You're a good friend. You're a good man. You've been to Haiti with us, ministered to the people there, and preached. And you've already preached a few places. You've spoken as a senior in high school to our young people. And you know what hard life can be like. And you know what the joy of the Lord is. Michael goes to college full time and also works.
That's true.
Tell them where you work.
I work at Auntie Anne's in the Johnson City Mall.
And you've worked there how long?
2 years.
Yeah, I went by to see him doing some Christmas shopping yesterday about 11. And it was an interesting crowd in the mall, the 11 bunch of guys like me. But anyway, you were there working, and you are, just praise God for you, brother. And I know that Andrew has played a major role in your life. I know that Blake has been there, and just thank you guys, your wives, for what you've been. Blake, if you'll come up and close us with prayer, and I'm just going to let you be here with him, okay? Thank you, Michael.
All right, let's pray. Father, I just thank you so much for allowing us all to come here today and just worship you. How awesome it is that Christmas was on a Sunday, that we get together and just get to congregate and praise your name and just thank you for all that you've done. Father, just it's really unreal when we think about that the God of the universe came down as a child and submitted himself and died for us. And just we just praise you for that. I ask today that as we go out, God, that the joy and the peace of Christ will just flow over everybody in here, and that as they go out with their families and friends, that we just can show that love and peace everywhere we go. Father, we love you, and we ask this all in Jesus' name. Amen.
I'm sorry, I want to mention one other thing. Dutch is sitting back here in a chair, camera in hand, and he just wants as a gift to the church. We talked about this yesterday. Anybody wants their pictures made in front of the Christmas trees as a family, anybody day, as long as you want to hang around, he's going to stay and take pictures. It's just, and he's already done that for a bunch, and he'll do it for anybody that wants a family picture made in front of the trees. Merry Christmas. right. You are dismissed.